Hello everybody. Today we're going to use balloons to make a vase or a cup. To make this sculpture I'm going to use two sets of 6 balloons in each set, total of 12 balloons. Inflate all balloons leaving about 8 cm flat tails. Twist the first about 6 cm long bubble. Lock the free end of the first bubble with the nozzle of the second balloon. We twist all bubbles of the same row of about the same size. Working in this way, we have to attach total of 6 balloons. The chain of first bubbles will make the first row of our vase. The free end of the last bubble of this row we have to lock with the nozzle of the first balloon. We can make vase of different size, different shapes. We can use as little as 2 balloons to make a vase. There are different weaving techniques to make different color patterns. In this particular example, I'm using pretty much the same weaving technique as we did in previously published instructions. Balloon cake, surfboard, umbrella, and some other balloon twisting instructions. You may find links to those instructions on my website, feedoit.com. Now I'm going to lock both ends of the first row in one lock twist. On my blog, I posted instruction how to make the same vase using rainbow color balloons. Easy to follow instruction. A link to the post you will find in the description to the video. Now we have to twist the second about 1, maybe 2 centimeters long bubble. It is a connection bubble. Then we twist the third bubble. Let's make it about 8 centimeters long. So the second row of bubbles we're going to make about 8 centimeters long in this example. All connection bubbles between each row we're going to make of the same about 1 up to 2 centimeters long, no more than 2 centimeters long. Twisting connection bubbles larger than 2 centimeters long will make visible gaps between rows. So keep in mind when you're making connection bubbles, try to make them no more than 2 centimeters long. In this particular example, all odd number bubbles will represent the bubbles of the row, and all even number bubbles will represent the connection bubbles. The bubbles of the first row I made about 6 centimeters long, and then in each following row I increase size of row bubbles, making them about 2-3 centimeters longer than in previous row. Right now I'm making the last bubble of the second row. The bubbles of the second row we made about 8, maybe 9 centimeters long. Here I have to pull the end of the last balloon between bubbles of the first balloon of this row. Alright, we have made the second row. Let's make no more than 2 centimeters long connection bubble. The third row bubbles we will make about 10, maybe 11 centimeters long. It could take about 20, maybe 30 minutes to make this a vase. I'm going to play back the video on higher speed for you to save time. And then I'm going to slow down to normal playback speed where I think it is important. As you can see, we work all balloons in the same way. Here we have to pull the end of the last balloon between bubbles of the first balloon. We have made the third row. Now we're going to work on the fourth row. Let's twist all bubbles of the fourth row, make them about 12, maybe 13 centimeters long. Using different color balloons, we can make different color patterns. In this example, I work all balloons moving around the sculpture in the same direction. With different color balloons, it would make zigzags or steps color pattern. Working balloons in different directions in different rows will make different color pattern. Okay, we have made the fourth row. In the following rows, I'm going to decrease size of bubbles in each row, subtracting about 2-3 centimeters from the size of the previous row. So let's make bubbles of the fifth row about 11, maybe 10 centimeters long. By changing size of bubbles in each row, we can get very different shapes. I want to make the bottom part of our sculpture shape of a ball, kind of round shape. Then I'm going to make a narrow neck with wide opening at the top of the waist. At this moment we already can use the sculpture to represent a bubble. You can fill it up with fruits and stuff like that. Or we can use the sculpture as it is now to represent a pot. Here I'm already finishing the fifth row. Here's the bottom view, the side view, the top view. Let's make bubbles of the sixth row about 9, maybe 8 centimeters long. Using more balloons we can actually get more rounded shape. Using less number of balloons you can get more visible corners of the sculpture. Right now we made the six rows. Let's make bubbles of the seventh row about 6, maybe 7 centimeters long. All my regular viewers are very well aware that I am using in all my instructions only one size balloons, always 260s. And also I'm always giving very approximately estimated size of all bubbles. Please use your own judgment trying to estimate proper size of bubbles when you're making your own sculptures. Now I'm going to attach a second set of balloons. As I mentioned before, I'm using the same color balloons. We have to tie nozzle of the new balloon to the end of the last bubble. Then we simply cut off the rest of the old balloon, tie off the end. I'm going to cut off ends of all balloons of the first set. Instead of cutting ends of the balloons, we can actually use them to make handles for our vase or some kind of decorations. I'm going to make it simple. Our vase will have no handles. As you can see in this example, I use set of first six balloons to make seven rows of our vase. And the rest of the sculpture I'm going to make using the second set of six pink balloons. Here I have to attach just one more balloon. You can cut off ends of the balloons using scissors. I am doing it with my hands. The long flat ends I simply hide inside of the sculpture, so you can cut them off with scissors if you want. Here's the side view and the bottom view. I'm going to twist bubbles of the next, the 8th row, make them about 5, maybe 4 centimeters long. Basically, we're already making the narrow neck for our vase. I'm not going to put many flowers inside of this vase. So the neck of this vase is going to be even less size in diameter than the bottom of the vase. Alright, here we have made the 8th row. Let's make bubbles of the next, the 9th row, about 2 centimeters long. When we're making smaller size bubbles of the row, it actually makes sense to decrease size of the connection bubbles between rows as well. Make sure you leave no gaps between rows. If you're making bubbles of the row about 2 cm size, then you should make the connection bubbles between rows about 1 cm size. Okay, here we have made the 9th row. With smaller size bubbles, it's getting harder to connect both ends of the same row. Let's make the bubbles of the 10th row about 2 cm long, about the same size as we did the previous row. We are making the narrowest part of our waist. We can use the same waving technique to make very different balloon sculptures. It could be any 3D objects, furniture, dresses, and so on. Here we have made the 10th row. This is the side view and the top view. Here's the bottom view. I think it is enough for the narrow neck. From now I'm going to increase gradually size of bubbles in following rows. Let's make bubbles of the 11th row about 3, maybe 4 cm long. I think in to make a couple more rows for my waist it would be enough. So if you want, you can make it a bit taller, make additional rows. It is all up to you. Here we finish in the 11th row. Let's make bubbles of the 12th row about 6, maybe 7 cm long. I think our sculpture already looks quite nice. I'm going to make it the last row. If you want, you can make the waist even taller, add a couple more rows, up to you. We have made the 12th row. Here's the side view of the waist and the bottom view. We can use the rest of the balloons to decorate the top of the sculpture. We can use just 2 balloons to make the handles. Or we can use all balloons to make some kind of flower, 6 petals flower. Just make the petals of the same size. Cut off any extra pieces. I'm going to make the flower on the top of this vase just for you to see how it looks like. You can make the petals smaller size if you want. I would rather make the vase without this decoration on the top. The petals we can rearrange in different ways. Here I'm making the last petal. Now we just have to fix bubbles in proper positions. We can bring the petals up like this. Or you can open the flower, make it flat. Congratulations, we have made the vase with flower on the top. Let's open the flower, make it flat like this. Now I'm going to cut off the petals. Oops, I dropped my vase. Good thing it's made of balloons, otherwise it will break on little glass pieces. Here we have a vase with two handles. I'm going to use scissors to cut off ends of the balloons. You can tie off the ends and hide them between bubbles of the sculpture. That's it. Here we have made the vase with two handles. In the same way, you can use it as a basket or a handbag. Now I'm going to cut off the handles as well. And that's it. Congratulations, we have made the vase. This way I like it the most. You can put a relatively heavy object inside of the vase. It helps to balance the vase on a flat surface. Now we can flip the vase upside down and use the vase as a cup. Here's an example of a vase I made using rainbow color balloons. I made 14 rows for the rainbow vase. Remember to subscribe to my channel. Like and share my videos with your friends. Leave comments. Have fun and happy twisting.